I got involved with that school because I'm working for DuPont and I took over the responsibility of public affairs and communications. And in that context, I decided to write a book on the history of our plant. And while doing this work, I discovered some documents about the DuPont private school in Luxembourg. And so I became aware that DuPont actually founded that school. So I investigated further into that so as to know how that went and or how it developed then into the International School of Luxembourg. In 1962, the Luxembourg government saw the necessity to diversify the economy. And so Luxembourg also contacted DuPont. And actually, DuPont wanted to build the Europe's first polyester film line somewhere in Europe. And so finally, DuPont decided that it would be built in Luxembourg. But one of the conditions of building these facilities was that the children of the personnel of DuPont would have a school, an American-style school, so that their school curriculum would not be disturbed. A very important person in this was Mr. Henri Müller. He was a school teacher with previous experience of teaching in the United States. He took himself the initiative to take these children to the Sessange Primary School. And he had a class for them, so there was one classroom in which about 15 or 17 pupils met. And that's where he was teaching several grades together in one class. And that was in early 1963. And by the end of 1963, the number of pupils had increased, and so this classroom was not sufficient. So the government decided to put at the disposal of DuPont this building situated here at the intersection of Boulevard Joseph II and Avenue Marie-Thérèse, known as the Survey House. And so the school entered into this building, and so there were several rooms at its disposal. So there could be several classes, and there were several teachers. There was Madame Parik, who took care of the lower classes. There was Mr. Lamborel. And then there were teachers like Mrs. Van Versch. And these were then kind of pioneers who set up a teaching program. So then he was able to build up first an elementary school and then a junior high school. And they had all the grades represented. Then Mr. René Schaaf became the first principal. And he was relayed afterwards by Mr. Albert Niklaus, a well-known politician who was a member of the Luxembourg City Council. Finally, in 1969, the government decided to build a school for the DuPont school pupils in Rue Alois Kaiser at Bel Air. And so the teaching got a very much higher scale, and it was no more the DuPont school. There was a familiar atmosphere here, and that every pupil was treated as an individual. There was a good follow-up, and that the school had a very good reputation from its beginning. And I think that also played a major part of the development of Luxembourg into an international banking center and into the diversification, and also in Luxembourg as an international city. This school, I think, was very important.